They play a key role in nursing an animal back to health. Today, let's learn about the animal health technologist. Hi, I'm Viviana.
Hi, Viviana, I'm Michelle. As a veterinary technician, we do many things. We take x-rays, take blood, place IV catheters, run samples through the lab to set up anaesthesia and monitor the animal under anaesthesia while the veterinarian performs their surgery. And we also provide emergency and critical care. I got into this by the fact that I really loved animals and I always had an interest in biology. I also found that as an animal health technologist, I actually get to spend a lot of time with the animals, which was my goal. I feel very lucky that I'm hands-on with the patient.
And what are we gonna do with Fergie here?
So before the doctor comes in to ultrasound, I'm just gonna get the probe on her and make sure everything's good. Great, so everything seems to be in order here, so we're ready for the veterinarian to come in and do his scan. One of the most important skills is being able to accept that you're gonna be learning all the time. It's always changing, so you have to be really willing to update and go to continuing education, being open to learning. A typical day for me would be coming in and going through the patients we have in hospital. I usually begin setting up for our day's surgeries, and then at the end of the day, I'm usually inputting on the computer my notes and bills, then often discharging the patients of that day. I work from 6:30 in the morning till 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It's not unusual for me to be asked to work overtime. Typically, we work 40 hours a week, and we're also expected to be on call. Here in British Columbia, we have two schools, I believe Douglas College in Vancouver and Thompson Rivers University in Kamloops. They usually require that you complete grade 12. The name of the program is Animal Health Technology, and it's a two-year program. Once you've finished your schooling, you then have a period of time to study for veterinary technician national exam. And once you've passed that, you then become registered animal health technologist. There are other avenues. You can work in a zoo hospital for the health of the zoo animals. You can work in feedlots for herd health. You can even work in animal shelters. It is a common misconception when I meet people that they think a veterinary technician is somebody who perhaps holds animals for the veterinarian, cleans up after the veterinarian. We do all of that, but we do a whole lot more too. We do the anesthesia, we do the x-rays. There's a lot that the veterinarian really relies on us to do for them.
What was your role in that surgery?
Well, actually, I was doing the anesthesia. So I was monitoring, seeing how he did under anesthetic, keeping him at a good level of anesthetic for the surgeon. Mm-hmm. And now that he's waking up, we're gonna make sure that he does okay. You do have to be diligent about record keeping. We work with controlled drugs. That's very important to be able to keep track of those. You work with a lot of numbers every day. I have to be able to calculate drug dosages in the lab. There is some math required in there, and putting bills in as well. My advice to anyone that's interested in a career like this would be to really talk to an animal health technologist or ask if you could job shadow with them for a brief period of time. I think that's really invaluable, just so you know what you're getting into. The most rewarding aspects of my job are the variety of what I get to see. I get to see large animals, I get to see small little animals. They might have fur, they might have feathers, they might have scales. I just love that variety. I also love that they can come in hurt or injured or sick, and it's very rewarding to see them get better and just get to go home.
Michelle, thank you so much. Today was a lot of fun shadowing you. I love animals, so this is a perfect job for me, actually.
Great. Well, you did a great job, and please,
anytime
you're back in Sanishin, come visit us.
I will. Thanks.
Thank you.
Once again, this is Career Trek, and I'm Viviana reminding you that this career could be yours. See you next time.